Alright, I'm going to start painting a few of the engine bolts. I'm not going to paint everything, all the attachments to the engine, but the cylinder head bolts and the crankcase bolts I'm going to paint so that they look nice. Here what I did was I took the old gasket, which I'm going to throw away but I still have, and I just kind of drew an outline. You know, I wasn't a very good tracer in school, but there it is anyway. And then I've got three of the bolts, head bolts, done. They're nice and shiny. They're wire wheeled, ready to go. These didn't come out that nice, but they're wire wheeled. This is the intake tube, and that's just gonna do. That's all there is to it. Here's the intake tube. I need to clean that yet, but you know, nothing to be done here. Other than cleaning that up, a little detergent and a brush, and that'll be that. And then I've got holes just cut into this box for the crankcase bolts. And you know, you can use a pizza box. Anytime I get a cardboard, big box of cardboard, I cut it out and save it. And also any of these thin boxes like this, I keep. Just to do this very same thing. So, and of course you can reuse the other side, and you know, use it for a long time before you have to throw it out. So put you on the stand here, and we'll do one bolt. It's all the same. I'm not gonna bore you with the whole process, but one of the things you is a must when you're doing this kind of thing is you have to wear heavy duty leather gloves, because you will slip at some point or another, and you're gonna get that wire wheel right in your hands, and that's gonna hurt. Also, you get, anytime you're using this machine here, a bench grinder, is a must. You must wear safety glasses. Any one of these little pieces of wire could let loose and go right in your eye, and that would not be good. So basically I just get in there, let me zoom in, get in there, just make sure you get a firm hold on it, firm grip on it. You can see what it looks like before. I'll show you another one that I've kind of started on. That there's a couple of them right there that you can see. They had black paint on them from the factory. That's what I'm taking off. The bolts are in pretty good shape. The threads are good. I'm not going to do anything to them. Basically, just a cleanup. There is one thread that had, if you see the disassembly video of the head, you can see the, there was one that had corrosion. This is it here. I'll probably wire wheel these threads here just to make sure that I clean them up. So here we go. It doesn't matter what you do first, the head or the... But if you do this, you'll get good adhesion on your paint. And if you let your paint cure long enough, and that's a mistake a lot of people make. They paint and they start putting it together the next day. It takes about a week to cure the paint to get a good, solid, baked on kind of look. So you really got to give it some time. So while you're ordering parts, a lot of times it's a good time to paint. I should have done this a long time ago, but I just didn't have the time. So I'm doing it now, and this will make me have to sit around a little bit and wait for the paint to cure. That's all right. It's all fun. I'm not doing this for money, so there is no rush job here. There you go. You can see I just hit my finger right there. It would have hurt a lot if I didn't have these gloves on. Because you can't see where the wire wheel is a lot of times, where the wires extend to, and then
you wind up hitting it by accident. Any place that the yellow dye is removed is where I've scuffed my fingers on the wire wheel. So there's that one done. I'll take the one that has the corrosion, and you can just lightly do the threads real quick. Get that aluminum oxide out of the threads. There you go, and then that's it. Don't do any more than you need to. There you go. There's a nice shiny finished head, and that's it. Maybe a before and after there.
Also, just as an update, I just took a wire wheel to the valves, really cleaned them up nice. The valve stems this time. Yeah, I did the valve seats, and those are all lapped and ready to go. All right, here's the bolts all painted up. And I got a little bit of the shank here, which will extend inside the head. And I think that'll protect the shank a little bit. Now letting these cure, and I didn't do anything with the bolts that I was going to do here. I'll show you those. That's here's one of them. These are the block, and I haven't touched them, and these things are in great shape. I honestly don't remember them coming out this clean when I took them out of the block, but there's no sense touching those. They're in real good shape. Still have, it looks like a black anodized coating. I don't know, it may be paint, hard to say. But these things are in great shape. I'm not touching those. Not doing any more work than I have to. Anyway, just a follow-up to that video.